Hi, this is Tammy from Tam's Crafts and More. I was going to do a video for you on putting this here vintage, not sure how to say it, crimspawn kit together. But I started the video, and with my bad eyes, I could not see what I was doing, and I just kept screwing everything up. So I thought we would do the finishing details together. And this way, if you want to finish one of these, you can see how it's done. But I've already put some ink, see if I can get that to focus for you, on the little pair of scissors. And what I'm using to do the finishing touches is Tim Holtz, the silver mixative. See if I can get that to come on there for you. And that's what I'm going to be using here. And I'm also going to be staining this with some brown paint and some water. I have a little cup here that I just put a little bit of water in. Just going to put some paint in there and make some stain. Stir that up. I just want this to be real runny, so this way I have a paper towel here and we're going to wipe it off. We're just going to take our watered down paint and just brush it on there. And you just take your paper towel and just dab it off. If you want it darker, you'll keep doing it. I like to just do little bits at a time to see how dark I actually want it to go. I'm just going to brush it around. Take our towel. Just dab a little bit more. Now, as you may or may not know, over on my Facebook group, I told you I was putting together a dollhouse. It's a one room, and I am making it. It is a craft store slash hardware, sort of like a Surplus City if you've ever been to anything like that before. And I'll be posting pictures over there. And I would love to be able to see what everybody is making themselves. And so if you'd like to join our group and share with us what you are making, we would love to see it, because I only have a couple people that actually post their projects on there, and I'd like to see a lot more and see my group grow. So if you're interested in that, the link will be down below for my Facebook group. Oops. Dribbled on the front there. But I want this to kind of look old, because as you can tell, it's not a new machine. That's all there is to staining these. Now, if you made, you know, not as much water, it would stain a lot darker. But I don't want mine real dark. I know the one my mom used to have, it was real dark, but I just want this one to look like it's been well used. But you don't want to rub the paint, because you'll rub it all off. You just want to dab it and real light, so this way you just take some of the paint. And like I said, once that's dry, I can go over it again if I want it to be darker. looks like it might need a couple coats. I'll have to wait for it to completely dry before I can do another coat. Now we're going to take this. I got the smallest brushes that I could find. I'm going to move this out of my way. So I know me, I'd end up spilling it. We're just going to put some little detail work here. I'm actually just going to use the tip of that. We're going to go around the outer edge of the wheel here. I think one of my pins just fell out. Must not have had enough glue on it. Yep. We'll glue that back in there. As you can see, I'm not a very good painter. But it will look used because I'm leaving some of the black show through. Just going to give this a little squeeze so I get a bubble. Come on. There we go. Now I got some on the top here. Now what we're going to do, I'm going to paint the faceplate here. Yeah, you'd have been laughing if you'd have seen me trying to see all these little pieces and parts. And oh, it was funny. Now, let's see if we can get the needle. That's a big needle for this. Oh, I don't think I was in view there. This little piece right here. Like I said, I want a little bit of the black to show through to where it looks like it's worn. So I don't want to put that on there too thick. Paint this little tip here silver too, to give it a little bit of extra. Now for the bobbin, let's see here. I have a gold in the ink also, so I think what I'm going to do is they're going to be using gold thread today, since I get this shook up. These have been sitting for a long time, so it'll take me a minute here to shake them up. There we go, that looks a lot better. Whoa! I just squirted that all over my mat. Alright, we'll just take it off of there. We'll just put some gold around this. Make it look like they're using gold thread. just a little bit there. Ah, I'm smearing it. I don't want to touch it. Alright, well, that's what there is to finishing this up. Like I said, I'm going to give this a couple more coats, and then on my Facebook page you will see what it looks like whenever it's totally finished. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you want to see what other videos I will be doing on the dollhouse, don't forget to subscribe and then hit the little bell so this way you know whenever I upload a new video. Well, thanks for watching. Bye.